Thank you for joining me for another reading through the Bible in chronological order. Today we are reading from Psalms 65 through 67 and 69 and 70. Double checking that, make sure that's right. Yes. Psalm 65, for the choir director, a psalm of David, a psalm. Praise is rightfully yours, God. In Zion, vows to you will be fulfilled. All humanity will come to you, the one who hears prayer. Iniquities overwhelm me. Only you can atone for our rebellions. How happy is the one you choose and bring near to live in your courts. We will be satisfied with the goodness of your house, the holiness of your temple. You answer us in righteousness with awe-inspiring works. God of our salvation, the hope of all the ends of the earth and of the distant seas. You establish the mountains by your power. You are robed with strength. You silence the roar of the seas, the roar of their waves, and the tumult of the nations. And those who live far away are awed by your signs. You make east and west shout for joy. You visit the earth and water it abundantly, enriching it greatly. God's stream is filled with water, for you prepare the earth in this way, providing people with grain. You soften it with showers and bless its growth, soaking its furrows and leveling its ridges. You crown the year with your goodness. Your carts overflow with plenty. The wilderness pastures overflow, and the hills are robed with joy. The pastures are clothed with flocks, and the valleys covered with grain. They shout in triumph. Indeed, they sing. Psalm 66, for the choir director, a song, a psalm. Let the whole earth shout joyfully to God, sing about the glory of his name, make his praise glorious. Say to God, how awe-inspiring are your works. Your enemies cringe before you because of your great strength. The whole earth will worship you and sing praise to you, and they will sing praise to your name, Selah. Come and see the wonders of God. His acts for humanity are awe-inspiring. He turned the sea into dry land, and they crossed the river on foot. There we rejoiced in him. He rules forever by his might. He keeps his eye on the nations. The rebellious should not exalt themselves. Bless our God, you peoples. Let the sound of his praise be heard. He keeps us alive and does not allow our feet to slip. For you, God, tested us. You refined us as silver is refined. You lured us into a trap. You placed burdens on our backs. You let men ride over our heads. We went through fire and water, but you brought us out to abundance. I will enter your house with burnt offerings. I will pay you my vows that my lips promised and my mouth spoke during my distress. I will offer you fattened sheep as burnt offerings with the fragrant smoke of rams. I will sacrifice bulls with goats, Selah. Come and listen, all who fear God. And I will tell what he has done for me. I cried out to him with my mouth, and praise was on my tongue. If I had been aware of malice in my heart, the Lord would have not listened. However, God has listened. He has paid attention to the sound of my prayer, and blessed be God. He has not turned away my prayer or turned his faithful love from me. Psalm 66, for the choir director with stringed instruments, a psalm, a psalm. May God be gracious to us and bless us. May he make his face shine upon us, Selah, so that your way may be known on the earth, your salvation among all nations. Let the peoples praise you, God. Let all the peoples praise you. Let the nations rejoice and shout for joy, for you judge the peoples with fairness and lead the nations on earth, Selah. Let the peoples praise you, God. Let all the peoples praise you. The earth has produced its harvest, God. Our God blesses us, and God will bless us, and all the ends of the earth will fear him. Psalm 69, for the choir director, according to the lilies of David. Save me, God, for the water has risen to my neck. I have sunk in deep mud, and there is no footing. I have come into deep water, and a flood sweeps over me. I am weary from my crying. My throat is parched, my eyes fail, looking for my God. And those who hate me without cause are more numerous than the hairs of my head. My deceitful enemies who would destroy me are powerful, though I did not steal, I must repay. God, you know my foolishness, and my guilty acts are not hidden from you. Do not let those who put their hope in you be disgraced because of me. Lord God of armies, do not let those who seek you be humiliated because of me, God of Israel. For I have endured insults because of you, and shame has covered my face. I have become a stranger to my brothers and a foreigner to my mother's sons, because zeal for your house has consumed me, and the insults of those who insult you have fallen on me. I mourned and fasted, but it brought me insults. I wore sackcloth on my clothing, and I was a joke to them. And those who sit at the city gate talk about me, and drunkards make up songs about me. But as for me, Lord, my prayer to you is for a time of favor. In your abundant, faithful love, God, answer me with your sure salvation. Rescue me from the miry mud. Don't let me sink. Let me be rescued from those who hate me and from the deep water. Don't let the flood waters sweep over me or the deep swallow me up. Don't let the pit close its mouth over me. Answer me, Lord, for your faithful love is good. In keeping with your abundant compassion, turn to me. Don't hide your face from your servant, for I am in distress. Answer me quickly. Come near to me and redeem me, ransom me because of my enemies. You know the results I endure, my shame and disgrace. You are aware of all my adversaries. Insults have broken my heart, for I am in despair. I waited for sympathy, but there was none. For comforters, but found no one. Instead, they gave me gall for my food, and for my thirst, they gave me vinegar to drink. And let their table set before them be a snare, and let it be a trap for their allies. Let their eyes grow too dim to see, and let their hips continually quake. Pour out your rage on them, and let your burning anger overtake them. Make their fortification desolate. May no one live in their tents. For they persecute the one you struck and talk about the pain of those you wounded. Charge them with crime on top of crime. Do not let them share in your righteousness. Let them be erased from the book of life and not be recorded with righteousness. But as for me, poor and in pain, let your salvation protect me, O God. I will praise God's name with song and exalt him with thanksgiving. That will please the Lord more than an ox, more than a bull with horns and hooves. The humble will see it and rejoice, you who seek God, take heart. For the Lord listens to the needy and does not despise his own who are prisoners. Let heaven and earth praise him, the seas and everything that moves in them, for God will save Zion and build up the cities of Judah. They will live there and possess it. The descendants of his servants will inherit, and those who love his name will live in it. Psalm 70. For the choir director of David to bring remembrance. God, hurry to rescue me. Lord, hurry to help me. Let those who seek to kill me be disgraced and confounded. Let those who wish harm be turned back and humiliated. Let those who say, aha, aha, retreat because of their shame. Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. Let those who love your salvation continually say, God is great. I am oppressed and needy. Hurry to me, God. You are my help and my deliverer. Lord, do not delay. So our reading of these five psalms today do show again the vast spectrum of emotion that prompts these psalms to be written. The first three are very strongly hymns of or songs of praise, calling God to glory, but the latter two are songs of clear lament and petition for God to rescue and redeem David, particularly Psalm 69, where it's very clear that there are messianic references. That is, these verses are applied in the life of Jesus to help us connect with and understand the significance of the events that are described. Let me find one of the examples. That's the most clear one. Verse 9 of Psalm 69, because zeal for your house has consumed me, is a reference to how the apostles describe Jesus's act against the evildoers in the temple. But here, the psalmist is mourning and fasting. He's wearing sackcloth. And the passion of even the lament is the same passion that drove Jesus to do the rite in the temple. And what does that all say? Well, I could probably say more than allotted for these kind of readings. But just to understand that sometimes you may find a strong overwhelming of emotion over an event or over something for which you don't understand why God is allowing those kind of things. And the purpose of the Psalms are to tell you and me to open up to God about what those emotions are. Lay them all out on the table for God to hear. Not only because in us saying them, do we get to hear what our heart really feels, but it allows us to put before God the truth of what we feel. And that's important because God can only heal us when we're truthful about what we need healed. So join me tomorrow for another reading through the Bible in chronological order.